This newsroom is where some political analysts see a main source of tension between Qatar and Egypt. Al Jazeera, the most popular news channel in the Arab world.
Of course, Egypt is often irritated at Al Jazeera coverage. And Al Jazeera is one of those unofficial tools with which Qatar tries to not only enhance its influence in the region, but also pursue its foreign policy objectives much more pointedly.
The tiny Gulf country of Qatar is able to insert itself in several regional conflicts. In doing so, it is stepping into a new role that Egypt played in the past.
But now the Qataris came up with a novel approach, which is that a smaller state with resources and vision can actually compete, not for leadership, but for influence.
Qatar mediated in recent major conflicts in the region, including the 2008 refugee camp uprising in Lebanon, the strife between Fatah and Hamas, and the relationship between Persian Iran and the Arab world, diplomatic leadership roles that Egypt traditionally has held. But the Egyptian ambassador to Qatar says regional influence goes beyond oil revenues and TV stations.
It has a lot of meaningless. It is not that you have a newspaper or you have a mass media manner that will make you an important player. You have to have the weight of a regional power to play that role.
A former Egyptian foreign minister says his country is still the dominant player in the Middle East.
I don't think you can say Egypt's role is diminishing. But as it is always said, the job is enormous. And I think many laborers are sometimes needed to try to help in solving problems.
Qatar is home to the United States' largest Air Force base in the Middle East, and the United States provides billions of dollars in aid to Egypt. Despite tension between Egypt and Qatar, the United States says it doesn't choose sides.
Well, I don't think that the enemy of my enemy is my friend. I don't think that's a particularly effective policy or one that's pursued. I think that the United States can be friends with all states of the region, given the identification of sufficient mutual interest.
Leaders from both countries say they hope to put these diplomatic tensions behind them. Onlookers will carefully watch upcoming Arab summits to see how the relationship between Egypt and Qatar continues to unfold. Reporting from Cairo, I'm Carrie Sheffield.